Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Welcome to Amazed by the Qur'an, a series in which I like sharing with you things I find amazing about the Qur'an. Today I'm going to compare two ayat to you, both of them are about fighting in the path of Allah. Both of them actually have to do with the context of the first battle in Islam, the battle of Badr, that happened soon after the Prophet migrated to Medina, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of these ayat belongs to Surah Al-Baqarah, and the other belongs to Surah Al-Anfal, which gives away something to you, something you can remember. The second surah and the eighth surah both deal with the battle of Badr. Okay. Now he says, among other things he says, وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ, fight them, حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةٌ, until there is no more tribulation. Fitna also means there's no more corruption. Okay, fitna is tribulation, when people are put in difficulty and tribulation, until there's no such thing left. وَيَكُونُ الدِّينُ لِلَّهِ, and وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ لِلَّهِ, and the religion and the way of life belongs to Allah again. And it belongs to Allah. That's it. That's what he said in Baqarah. Similar expression in Anfal, he says, وَقَاتِلُوهُمْ حَتَّى لَا تَكُونَ فِتْنَةً, fight them until there is no more tribulation, no more trial, no more corruption. وَيَكُونَ الدِّينُ كُلُّهُ لِلَّهِ, and the religion in its entirety belongs to Allah. So in one case he said the religion belongs to Allah, and the other he said the religion in its entirety belongs to Allah. Now, peculiarly, they both have to do with the Battle of Badr. But this I wanted to share with you for a couple of reasons. I don't want to give you a long lecture about when and when not is fighting in the path of Allah legitimate. That's a long subject. The simple point that I'd at least like to make on that note is that the Muslims have been expelled from their home unjustly. And they are now justified in fighting back from the homes from which they have been expelled without engaging in violence themselves. They are in every right to fight back for the home that they have been expelled from. Now, in that context, the Muslims are actually, at that point, very few in number with almost no military resources. And the enemy that's coming after them within 6 months is actually very powerful, well-equipped, three times the size. And in that moment, Allah says to the believers, you need to fight them until the religion belongs to Allah. By the way, when anybody thinks of religion in Arabia, in the entire region, when they think of religion, they think of the Kaaba. They cannot think of religion outside of thinking of Mecca. Because everybody's idols, every tribe's idols, reside where? In Mecca. So when he says the religion belongs to Allah, for the Arab of the time, there is no difference in thinking that the religion belonging to Allah cannot happen until Mecca belongs to Allah. That can't happen. Now they're engaging in fighting, and Allah is saying, yes, you're fighting because you were kicked out of your homes, you're fighting because you've been oppressed, but you understand, you're going to keep fighting until the house is cleansed. You're going to keep fighting until the Kaaba is restored to its original legacy of Abraham. So fight them until there's no more tribulation. What is tribulation here? The tribulation of corruption that spreads from false religion. You need to get rid of these false religions in this region. وَيَكُونُ الدِّينُ لِلَّهِ, and the religion must belong to Allah. And until the deen belongs to Allah, the religion belongs to Allah. The cool thing is that this ayah in Baqarah is before the Battle of Badr. That's the difference. The key difference is this ayah is before the Battle of Badr. The Muslims don't even know how things are going to turn out. And they're already being told, you're going to keep fighting until the whole thing, until the religion belongs to Allah. Then they engage in the Battle of Badr. And Allah gives them victory in the Battle of Badr. Completely unlikely odds, and the Muslims have been given victory. And then Allah comments again and says, remember what I told you in Baqarah? I'll tell you again now, fight them until there's no more fitna. And the deen in its entirety belongs to Allah. Now when the Muslims hear, in its entirety, after being victorious in battle, they're like, yeah, in its entirety. There's this motivational speech in Surah Al-Anfal, where now the Muslims are empowered and they understand that Allah is not, if Allah said in the beginning, the religion in its entirety must belong to Allah, that would have been intimidating. But now that they've seen results, they've seen Allah's help come, their faith has been empowered, they're seeing that they can accomplish something, Allah actually ups the standards and says, not just the religion belongs to Allah, all of it belongs to Allah. We will cleanse the entire region of shirk. That's what we're going to do, you see? The principle here that I'd like to highlight, that's really the golden rule that's coming out of all of this, is that we must motivate people. But we shouldn't motivate them to the point where they get intimidated. We're going to change the world this year. Take it easy. Have milestones. Set yourself a target. Set yourself a goal. Be realistic about it. Motivate people to accomplish that goal. And once they accomplish that goal, introduce them to a bigger horizon. Then introduce them to it. Don't just give people the entire horizon at once. No, give them a milestone. Do this. focus on this, accomplish this. And once they accomplish that, then show them the bigger picture, you see? And so that's really, really important. Because you know when you talk about the bigger picture all the time, and you don't talk about what's right in front of you, then you just keep talking about the bigger picture and get nothing done. Pie in the sky. Everything stays pie in the sky. You have to have immediate goals and you have to have long-term goals. And inshallah, once you accomplish some immediate goals, you become more empowered and more confident that you have the ability to accomplish and make changes. You've made significant progress. It's nothing compared to the grander goal. Obviously, Badr is just the beginning. There's a lot of challenges that lie ahead. But you are now feeling empowered that this is something that can be done. And so Allah brings along more motivation by saying in its entirety, the deen must belong to Allah. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us good planners and good visionaries so that we can set goals for ourselves and the people around us in a way that is on the one hand realistic and on the other hand very high, aiming very, very high. إِذَا تَمَنَّيْتَ فَاسْتَكْثِرْ When you're going to aim high. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us of those people. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.